Welcome back to the Mayorverse, everybody. Mayor Reynolds, aka Midnight American. I just got back to New York. I just came back from the Deadrop Snapshot 7 reveal event in Las Vegas, and boy oh boy, was it a wild ride. I've got tons of stuff to share with you, to talk about, give feedback about the event itself, show you so much. What a wild ride, guys. Snapshot 7 is out. Let's just get right into it. First and foremost, I just want to thank the entire Midnight Society team. We got to meet so many of the developers, they're honestly all great, super passionate, very open about Deadrop, sharing their ideas, their thoughts, their preferences, like, hey, we've considered this. Seriously, thank you to every single one of the developers who was there. The event as a whole was amazing. The production was great. It was very exciting. The crowd was definitely super engaged. It was great to meet so many members of the community, other streamers, creators, players, fans, all that sort of thing. It was really, for me, a first of a kind experience. You know, I haven't attended a live esports event before, and this was kind of like that, but more community oriented as well. So overall, one of the big takeaways I had from this event, the developers of this game, the team at Midnight Society, they're the real deal. They're very much thinking about this game. They're giving it their all. They're being so open. I mean, it was great. I got to sit there for at breakfast like 2 days with some of the devs and just shoot the breeze about different aspects of the game. And you know, they're saying, no, well, we've thought about this and well, we've thought about that. So if you're one of those people that's like not sure about how game developers apply themselves to their job or whatever, you know, this team is they're for real. They're as passionate as the fans are. They love what they're doing. They love this game and they're giving it their all. Rest assured, 100%. And you know, we got to meet so many people. I met Rob. I met Quinn in the gym of all places. I met Sumit, obviously the doc meet and greet was great. You always want more time with all these people, of course. So I got to meet all four of the founding members of Midnight Society. And then again, so many of the devs from the art team to level design, to infrastructure, you know, basically the whole team was there. I know a couple, a few couldn't make it, but by and large, the entire development team was there. And it was so great. Every single one of them engaged, passionate, open, talking about the game, even asking. I know a lot of my conversations were like, hey, what do you think about this? Like what if we tried this? And this, to have that level of access with game developers, I've never had that. I have never experienced that. So for me, this experience was amazing, engaging, and motivational to come back and create more content and go even deeper into Deadrop because I see the team's passion. Back to my experience in Vegas, guys. I mean, my experience was great. I got to see Infection, the icon at least, you know, the thumbnail live on stage, my mode, which I have a video coming on that tomorrow. That was incredible. I also got interviewed live during the show about Infection, about Midnight, my live action series. Got to meet Goge. He's the one who interviewed me. Great. For me, it was an honor. I was thrilled to be part of the production. And just that part of my experience, loved it. By the way, huge thank you to Midnight Society. Midnight, my live action Deadrop short film, was playing in the lobby during the event at the venue at HyperX Arena. I didn't even see it for myself. Somebody sent me photos of it. It was actually Shats Will Fire. Thank you, sir. But again, huge thank you there. Again, I'm talking about just my experience. That's what this video is about. Incredible moment for me as a creator that Midnight Society literally enabled. One piece of feedback that I do have specifically about the actual the Deadrop showdown, you know, where we had Dr. Disrespect and Z-Laner and others playing the new snapshot on stage, and you know, this event was viewed by over 500,000 people or something like that just on YouTube alone. I think the lobbies were about 11 people, and it definitely had its moments. Like, it had exciting moments, and I just think it would be more representative of the game as a whole, the overall experience would be that much more exciting, the showdown portion of the show, if those lobbies were more full, more along the lines of the you know, 20 to 30 players. So, you know, maybe next time, and I know it depends on the venue and so on and so forth, and we'll get to that in a minute. HyperX Arena was awesome, by the way. Very intimate, but very exciting arena at the same time. it'd be great to have 20, 30 players, even if they're not there, even if there's people at home prepared to play or whatever, using a private key, because I imagine that's what they did. I think the event will be that much more exciting for everybody there. The people playing on stage, you'd get more of those moments, like when somebody attempted a 360 no scope during the event. That was pretty sick. I think that'd be an improvement on the showdown in itself. When it comes to merch, there was tons of options, and again, this is one of those founder exclusive things, including this Deadrop racing jacket. I really love this. I'm gonna be wearing this a lot on stream. Got the Roccat Dr. Disrespect mouse pad. This thing is massive. We got a badge, of course, for the event. Deadrop tote bags. We got posters, of which this one's not signed. My other copy is signed, but it's Art of the Cars, obviously, which are a huge part of Snapshot 7. There was more stuff. There was stickers. There was grenades. Tons of stuff. Tons of stuff. So this brings us to a few questions, you know, feedback, all that sorts of thing. Where's the next event going to be? When's the next event going to be? I would definitely go to another event. I had a blast at this one. My wife is not a gamer. She came with me. She had a good time meeting everybody. She felt like it was a very, you know, social environment and very, very exciting. So here's my request. Definitely, I mean, I'd prefer East Coast again because I'm on the East Coast. I'm in New York, but I know there's people in the Midwest as well. We've had three events in a row, I think, on the West Coast, right? Because we had LA, Arlington, and now Vegas. I know it's my own choice to go, but Vegas definitely milked me dry. The costs there are absolutely crazy as far as just, you know, staying in Vegas and being in Vegas. What else? What other venues are out there? I don't know. I know there's people who are talking like they'd love to see Chicago. I know maybe there's a Southeast. I personally prefer much more north, but you know, there is Florida over there. Where's the next event gonna be? Right now it's looking like every two snapshots, guys. So I'd expect maybe something in spring, but who knows? I know I'm looking forward to it though, that's for sure. One of my only regrets, and I mean only, is that, you know, I didn't get home until today, Tuesday, to actually play Snapshot 7 in depth. They did have it playable there, obviously, on the show floor, so to speak. But, you know, I could have gone home the next day, technically. But my wife and I chose to go to Utah, go camping there after the show. Amazing experience, by the way. Photos on my Instagram page, Mayor Reynolds TV. If you want to see them, photos don't do it justice. It was way more enjoyable than I thought it was going to be. But, you know, that's my only regret, that I couldn't be home playing and streaming Snapshot 7 as soon as it released. So that's basically it for this video, guys. I just wanted to share my excitement and my experience, some of the photos that I posted on Twitter and Instagram as well of the event. It was an incredible experience getting to meet so many members of the Deadrop team and the folks at Midnight Society, other creators, other streamers. Not only within the Deadrop community, like the direct Deadrop community, but, you know, I met this there. Obviously, American Dad was on stage. Dr. Lupa was there. I didn't get to meet Z-Laner because he was, like, off doing something when I came through in the meet and greet line. But, of course, Doc, all the founders of the studio, and everybody across the board on the team, and the community for that matter, was just incredible. Everybody was excited to be there. Positive, and it was a great experience that I hope I can have again. So that's it for this video, guys. We'll see you in the next one. I'm gonna be streaming Deadrop non-stop now that I'm home, so make sure you come join me, twitch.tv/mayorreynolds, to catch all the gameplay. I have a ton of content lined up for you guys. An infection video coming tomorrow, weapon meta guide coming soon, a new map guide on the new proving ground map, the DCM roadmap, that's gonna be a video. So much coming. So make sure you subscribe to the channel for more Deadrop and Midnight Society content. We'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching. Mayor Reynolds out. This video is sponsored by G Fuel Energy, a sugar-free energy drink available in both powdered and canned form. And you can get 20% off using code MAYOR at discount. That's just MAYOR, M-A-Y-O-R. Right in checkout, it's gonna get you 20% off. There's a ton of good flavors, including this new Cyberpunk 2077 Phantom Liberty flavor. If you need a competitive edge, guys, something to keep you up on those late nights or just get you hyped for whatever the latest release is, look no further than G Fuel Energy and use code MAYOR to get a discount on your order and support my content and channel at the same time.